This is Guardian Radio, your station for up-to-the-minute news, intelligent, interactive, and engaging conversation. 96.9 FM. The views and opinions of the hosts and guests are their own and do not necessarily reflect the position of the management and staff of Guardian Network.
The aftermath of every social revolution brings about change. Cultural norms and landmarks shift as our minds and hearts expand beyond the familiar. To everything, there is a season and a time to every purpose in the land of the living. This is our time to renew, revive, and restore the hope lost to the busyness of life. This is our time to dig again and rebuild from the storms of our past on a solid footing that holds. Welcome to The Foundation.
The Foundation. Foundation.
The Foundation of Hearts Grant is brought to you by Acretio Hair Growth, Alive, Baja Retreat and Spa, Bahamas Welding and Fire, Bonva Bones, Burger King, Commonwealth Bank, ESC Distributors Limited, Grand Bahama News, Kelly's Home Center, the Ministry of Tourism, the National Insurance Board, Popeyes, Prince Masters, and Ron's Electric Motors.
Foundation.
Just kick a little something for them cars that be bumping.
Something real smooth. You can just ride to. Tell me how you feel. Here we go.
Hold tight, hold tight. So we have a hold tight, hold tight, hold tight. So we have a hold tight. Tell them it's a cat, tell him off the old tight. Tell them first class, everything is alright. Coming out the place and you're feeling right. You're coming out the place and you hold your girl tight. Tell them it's a cat, him a DJ tonight, say hold tight.
Everything seems nice and bright and everything feels alright. I went to school without a food, trying to pick a fight. I was loped out, crisscross shirts and khakis.
Looking and feeling like nothing but a maxi.
The bell rang and I got my
good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. 96.9 FM Radio. Howard Grant in your company, The Foundation. It is an absolutely glorious day. I'm grateful to be in the land of the living and I hope that you are. I am happy. My producer tried to get funky with me. I said, I don't know. Just give me something funky. Give me something nice and tight. Going all the way back to Crisscross and Super Cat, right? I'm so happy for that, guys. I hope that you're having a good day. I hope that everything's good out there. I got to shout out to my good, decent people over at Da Vinci's, right? Da Vinci's. I'm grateful that you guys are continuing to be able to partner with us and talk about what they got going on over at Da Vinci's Printing Innovators. They got absolutely everything. If you're looking for graphics, if you're looking for anybody to be able to assist you in those areas, you got to go to Da Vinci. They are absolutely superb. I'm grateful for them to be able to forge a relationship with us and continue to be able to push them forward. Guys, Da Vinci Printing and Innovators, they are on the intersection of Village Road, Bernard Road, Soldier Road, and Wolf Road. All of the roads right there on the northern side, on the left hand, on the right hand side, you can be able to get them. And they'd be more than happy to assist you. Let them know that Howard Grant sent you over there. And they take very, very, very good care of you. Guys, also, I got a shout out to my good, decent people over at AFS Insurance Agents and Brokers. They got everything laid out for you. You know that they open up 6 days a week. Saturdays, they open up 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. to be able to assist you with all manner of things. Insurance. If you got your Estes, your Jitneys, your taxis, your liveries, whatever vehicles that you have in bulk, and you're looking to be able to get insured, you may not have the cash up front, but they can be able to assist you as it relates to you guys getting that thing taken care of, as it relates to working in that space, in-house financing. So you want to be able to assist that and get those things taken care of, right? I also want to be able to tell you guys, make sure you check out the Guardian newspaper, man. All the information's in the paper today. I don't know what, it's 12 o'clock, right? It's a little after 12. And I know that if you didn't have an opportunity this morning to kind of pick up your paper on your way to work, please don't neglect to either check us out or check us out at the NassauGuardian.com, right? The NassauGuardian.com, you can be able to see that. Also, you can pick us up at the GuardianTalkRadio.com, GuardianTalkRadio.com here, and you can be able to see us live in full effect. I'm right here on the camera, so you can be able to see that. Guys, it's a beautiful day. Like I said, pick up your Nassau Guardian, find out more information exactly what's going on there. Pintard used the House time to campaign. This is what Monroe indicated. Minister of National Security has taken on this kind of a posture to identify and, presumably, amplify the concept and idea of Pintard being able to use this time in the House of Assembly to be able to display his strengths, to display his vigor, and kind of make a run for it again as a leader of the Free National Movement. I don't necessarily know that's what it is. I don't know if that's what he's doing. Maybe some undertone. I'm not going to fight him. I think he needs to do everything he can to be able to prove himself in this particular capacity. I think everyone should. I think that their relentless reliance on internal politics and those calls that are being made behind the scenes and the collateral that exists behind the scenes can be able to support your run. I think that's a cheap way of being able to get any position, any position from a political standpoint. I just want to say it like that. Today's a laid-back Friday. We can try to do our best to recline, right? We can do our best to kind of kick back and have these conversations. There's a lot happening in the news from that particular perspective. Also, Monroe hits the MP concerned on the judges. Mitchell lashes out the licensees group for the Graham Hammer Port Authority. I saw some stuff come across my phone this morning. He has me in sort of a group. And so he's put some information out this morning to talk about the Grand Bahama Port Authority and those particular, you know, the campaigns that has started behind the scenes that continues to be able to perpetuate a certain idea and being able to push that forward. I'd like to touch that today also. Just a little touch, just a little taste. But more specifically, I want to talk about this concept and idea that has to do with collateral. I want to do that. I want to talk about consistency, collateral, and leaning on your convictions to step in a position. I know that all of us will do our absolute best to, if we envision something, we started to talk about this. If we envision something, we'll do whatever it takes to get to that objective. Now, unfortunately, some people will lose all manner of conviction, substance, belief, faith, everything to do with righteousness. They will shred that and believe that they can be able to have that reinstated once I attain this thing. Can I talk like this? Can we talk like this? Let's talk like this. There is this belief that exists in the political, in national political. Can we say it like that? Okay. That in the pursuit of a desired objective, in the pursuit of being able to acquire a seat, a position in government, that whatever it takes to get that, you got to get it first. Whatever it takes to get that, you have to get it first. And then grace, the Bahamian grace, God grace, those people that you went against, their grace, and being able to appeal to their good nature, hopefully all that will be reinstated after you understand why I had to get here in the first place. But it often doesn't work like that. Now, what happens is that after you realize that the poison that you used worked for you to get your objective, you tend to go back to that cistern. My God, I gotta calm down. You tend to go back to that cup. And as the tips of your fingers shift colors as though you indulge in some nefarious activity, and as it darkens from fingertip all the way down to your knuckles, this is proverbially, of course, because these are the things that happens when you put your hands to darkness. I just want to be decent with you as I say this. You have shifted the character of not only the organization and how people view your organization, because the organization, I often say this to you, organizations are not corrupt. Organizations and the constitution, rather, of the organization cannot be corrupt. Okay? You identify the constitution of the PLP, you identify the constitution of the FNM, you identify the Democratic constitution, the Republican constitution, you understand that there was an overarching objective of being able to move towards goodwill, growth, and development for the sector, subsector, and eventually, or overarchingly, the country. Constitutions cannot be corrupt. But what we find is a corrupted action is the rhythm of tradition that exists. See, some time ago, someone puts aside, we know what the Constitution says. Let's put that aside. Boom. We understand what the Constitution says. Let's push it aside. Let's get to our objective. Then we can reinstate these convictions. Don't worry about that. Let's push that aside. So you push it aside. And boom, the PLP was formed. Then the PLP got in. They did everything they were supposed to do. And being able to pursue those things, this was a righteous group of men with passion and determination to be able to build the country. And then in slips this sort of ego. This sort of an idea, this power that went from a mustard seed into a monster and took up residence in people's hearts. Their convictions were shifted. And as a result of the shifting conviction and position that these men have taken, watch me, the Freedom Fighters was formed. Can I say this? Can we see the nature, the rhythm of what's happening? Free National Movement found itself in the position of being able to yell at the PLP and say, you stole the 1987 election, you've done these things, you've gone contrary, the country is for sale, paradise is for sale, you've done all these things. So, boom, they won in 1992. In 2002, in comes the PLP again. After the totalitarian leadership and mindset that says that I know all, I know the right way, the country shifted. And as a result of the country shifting, in comes former Prime Minister Perry Christie, who, as I travel through my mind to identify what 2002 and 2007 meant for the PLP and the legacy of former Prime Minister Perry Christie, I couldn't identify it. Because it was every man for themselves, for the most part. So they came back, 2012, here comes Ingram again. And as a result of the reinsurgence, restoration and revival of the same totalitarian mindset, nothing shifted, here emerges another organization out of the Free National Movement, the DNA. See, because constitutions stand steadfast. And once there's conviction amongst those people that serve who has a desire to get back to a true north, there will be separation. Now we're seeing in the Free National Movement where there is sort of a angelic voice overarching about the need to be able to get back to where we have to. There's sort of this sort of an idea as many of us observe the organization and quietly try to figure out, will you get back to your true north? Will you get back to your constitution? Will you get back to transparency? Will you get back to the true representation and depiction of what democracy is? So we look on. And we look on with the expectation of realignment. But all we see, based upon allegations, speculations, murmurs, and those persons who have the wherewithal to come to the public, what we're seeing is much of the same old style of leadership. And so my question to you is that, are we getting anywhere with this? Are we getting anywhere with this? I've looked at this, and then I've identified the leadership in the organization. The leadership between Ingram and Minnis, more specifically. And in identifying those types of leadership, I've deduced, just looking, that the Ingram era was not over. It might have been, turned down significantly during the time that Minnis was in. But we recognize his representation right now. I'm going to talk like this. And then I want to talk about conviction as we started off to. That men will do whatever it takes and push past their faith, their convictions, and all the utterances that they've released to the public over the course of time simply for acquisition. But not knowing, as you put your foot, your finger to this proverbial darkness, that you morph entirely. Yes, this is metaphoric because I don't care to be able to insult anyone. I only want to talk about what I see in terms of representation in this kind of a space. I only want to be as decent as possible. And as I do this, I'm looking at this and I'm saying there can be no change. There can be no change in the organization if it continues this path. There must be transparency. There must be a presentation of vision and an affirmation of conviction for us to know that this is the course that we want the country to go on. I want to talk decent. I listened to former Prime Minister Ingram, Minnis last evening, sat with Jerome, all right? And when he sat with Jerome, I just listened. And for the most part, I thought it was an excellent interview. I really did. As I listened in, I listened to Jerome, and it felt like I know Jerome to be poised, to be methodical, to be, you know, have everything in place in terms of questions, so forth and so on. But it felt like that specific interview was at the drop of a dime. It happened real quick, right? And so as I watched it, I listened for the question, and Jerome dug deep down into the archives of his memory and the sentiments that bubbled to the surface during the time of former Prime Minister's leadership. And as a result of that, he took on this posture and position that, okay, let me ask these questions. I won't get into that, ladies and gentlemen. I won't talk about it. The line's going to be wide open today. Please give me a call, 323-6232, 325-4316, 325-4259, anywhere from the Family of Violence, 242-300-5720. Hit me up, 422-4796. Let me take this quick commercial break and be right back after this.
Foundation. John Bull presents its annual Mother's Day Garden Party. Shop new spring collection for her. Redefine your style. Find inspiration as you browse this season's standout. Be entertained. Special live art and music feature with Preston Hannah and DJ Super Mario. There will be photo keepsakes, gift personalization, perfume engraving, and henna. There's a spring style showcase. Dress in your season's best. Sign up for their spring fashion walk in store for a chance to win a $500 gift card. Scope out the latest scents, skincare, and makeup trends. There will be in-store raffles, gifts with purchase, and gourmet bites and beverages. Indulge in sweet delights. That's Saturday, May 11th, 11 a.m. to 5 p.m. at John Bull 284 Bay Street. That's John Bull's annual Mother's Day Garden Party, hosted by the Natural Empress.
Are you ready for the best of the best? Keep the Vibe Alive Music Group up for sound promotion, and Guardian Radio presents the best of the best Reconscript Explosion Concert. Mark your calendars for May 11th as Superclub Breeze's grounds ignite with Bahamian talent featuring KB, Gino D, Funky D, Veronica Bishop, The Brylanders, Avi, Elon Moxie, and Shine 242. Join the Falcons, Iron Store, Jovi Pierre, Johnny Cake, Mama D, Nishi LS, Pat Rami, Stevie S, and Shad Colley and the VIPs for an electrifying night of music and culture. Tickets are flying, so grab yours now. Available online at BahamasEtickets.com or swing by the Beauty Shack on Soldier Road and Carmichael Road. This is the event of the year. The best of the best Rake and Scrape Explosion at Breezes Resorts. Gates open at 6 p.m. Don't miss out on the Bahamian Magic.
Mothers are the heart of our homes, the soul of our memories, and the guiding light through life's journeys. Show your love with a gift from Kelly's House and Homes Mother's Day Sale, Friday, May 3rd through Saturday, May 11th. Enjoy 20% off selected dinnerware, glassware, luggage, silk flowers, and picture frames, except on net items. One lucky person can win a gift basket for Mother's Day. Visit our Facebook page for more information. Kelly's House and Homes Mother's Day Sale, May 3rd through 11th. Happy Mother's Day, all with love from Kelly's House and Home.
Great news! Ron's Electric Motors' new location on Cowpen Road, right next to Island Luck, is open Saturdays and Sundays. So for those needing repairs on electric motors, generators, welding machines, water pumps, battery chargers, electric lifts, transformers, and power tools, Ron's Cowpen Road location can have you up and running on weekends. Don't forget, you can still visit Ron's Electric Motors on Wolf Road and Claridge Road, and now Ron's new location on Cowpen Road. Dial 356-0249 or 323-5267.
It's a special day for Mom, and she deserves the best. Bring her into Baja and let's de-stress. We'll pamper her and make her feel safe. Get Mom a nice spa day.
Come visit us at Baja Retreat Spa. Purchase a gift for Mom and call us today at 323-6711.
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
Foundation. The foundation. The foundation.
And we are back, ladies and gentlemen, 96.9 FM radio, Howard Grant and your company, The Foundation. Beautiful day. Hopefully you get into a great conversation. I'd love you to do so. The numbers again, 323-6232-325-4316-325-4259. Anywhere for the family violence, 242-300-5720. Hit me up, 422-4796. I want to introduce you to my very good friend in studio with me today, none other than Goth, Rosebar Goth. Say good afternoon to people out there.
Hello, Bahamas. Hello, world. Howard, you know, it's Friday. End of a hard week. It's pretty warm. I think the summer is going to be extremely hot. So for those people who drive all day, you need to have your air conditions working, your homes. You want those properly insulated. Make sure you have your air conditioning and put away some of that money, Howard, that you're making now for the high electrical bills for the summer.
Money are you making now?
Well, whatever you're making now, you got to put some aside because it can be hard as ever. Let me tell you what happened yesterday. Your shirt is the color of what's happening right now. I was working around the house all day yesterday. I looked up at the house, and 40 feet up in the air, honey is dripping from my roof down to the ground. It was that hot yesterday.
Really?
It is that hot. So that's a telltale sign to me that this is going to be an extremely hot summer. But that also
but
being
the
said...
The hive ain't even holding on to the honey.
Can't even hold the honey. The wax is melting. And that also could mean that if we don't have sufficient rain this year, you know what happens next? We have to be prepared.
Forest fires, bushfires, so forth and so on.
Hurricanes. We got to be prepared. We have to be prepared. So we have to start paying attention, what I'm saying, to the environment around us. There's so many distractions, violent crimes and politics and everything else. But look around your
environment. It's amazing
environment.
That you put them two together, violent crime and that was funny to me.
Well, you know how at the foundation, you've always been a caring person for the family. Yes. So I'm only saying this in the language of family, that you want to protect your loved ones. Mm-hmm. And so now's the time to look at your environment. Make sure you don't have no debris around your house and clean up around your area. Make your neighborhood nice and cleanly and ensure that, you know, if anything does happen, there's no debris flying everywhere. This is the time to do it now.
I got a couple calls this morning, right? I went to get a haircut. I got a couple calls this morning. And, you know, I try to have a conversation, but I can't talk loud in the barbershop. Mm-hmm. And as I'm talking on the telephone and, you know, to these particular persons from a political standpoint, I am encouraging and then I'm inquiring in some instances. About what exists within the Free National Movement. Some people call me and say to me, Howard, you've had the Free National Movement and more specifically a character within the organization for lunch for the past 2 weeks. And I said to them, I will take a fast. I'll go on a fast.
Take a break from that?
I'll take a fast.
So you slept well last night?
I sleep well all the time.
But you didn't sleep the other day. You was up all night.
I was disappointed in the concept and idea of
But you're over that.
Yeah, okay, I'm good. I got it off my chest. I was good. Able to talk about it. All right. I had to deal with it, right? I was indifferent with the fact that persons are calling me and not providing me a resume of accomplishments, but merely asking for an opportunity to avert your eyes, that was disappointing to me. That was disappointing.
But the Bahamian people have never asked for a resume. Never.
Yeah, but because that's the rhythm of what we exist in.
Yes.
From a political standpoint.
Yes. So why would they start giving resumes now?
But you want, that's the first thing you say, why would you, what qualifies Howard Grant for these things? So you're asking for a resume, but when you start to get it, you don't really want that.
No, you don't want it.
You don't want that. You just want to know if I like Howard.
That's correct.
That's it.
That's it.
Do we like Howard?
But I think they do.
No, I don't mean me specifically. That's a question that people have.
All the time.
And then the thing about it is this. When you're indifferent about whether or not you like Howard, someone from the background who campaigned for you would call and say, listen, I know you may not know Howard. You may not even like Howard. But do this for me.
Ah, behave, Howard. It's Friday, man. It's Friday, Howard. You're talking about that ventriloquist.
How can we? No, I ain't talking about nobody today. I told you I'm taking a fast.
But you just said do it for me. That sounds familiar.
It may sound familiar and allow it to linger in your mind, but I'm only asking.
How do you can't get away from that?
I'm only asking you. I have to stand on my worth and my merit as a man.
You do.
Every one of us, you do also.
No, you could say they should, but they don't.
We got to stand on, what they say, what old people say?
Yeah, but I don't work in the Bahamas.
Tub.
You just want to be in the tub. They remember the bottom. These fellas want to be to the top of the tub. That's all. Because the water to the bottom of the tub coming out first.
You know who else was at the top of the tub? Walking on the edge?
Who?
John Kerry.
My friend?
Kerry. President.
Oh, that Kerry.
Yes, candidate for...
Oh, you went to the United States now?
Yes.
Okay.
And he was teetering on the edge and... Bush called him a flip-flopper, and what happened to him? He fell into the bathwater and died.
So the best place to be in the tub is in the middle of the water.
The best place is to be firm on your feet, on your own merit and worth. Why is it when you start to deduce and identify character, quality, capability, or lack thereof in individuals is an issue? It's an issue. The very first thing, if I'm going for a promotion... I went for this promotion within the hotel one time. I was doing so well. Listen to me. I was doing well at the hotel. In my mind.
In your mind, yeah. Go ahead.
In my mind.
But in their mind,
and so it's time to be able to get evaluated.
Uh-huh.
And so the evaluation was out of, let's say, 15. It was out of 15 points. So if you hit all the points, you get 15. I got 14 of the points. And I couldn't understand why I didn't get 15 of the points. And so I asked the assistant manager at the time, why didn't you give me 15 of the points? And she had no good reason other than her emotions and her feelings. And she said, Howard, if I give you 15 points, then you might as well take my job.
That's how it works. That's how it works, Howard.
But that doesn't mean that I'm not worth the 15 points, sir.
I agree with you, but
that
that's how it
works.
That
doesn't mean that my value and my commitment over the 365 days of being able to develop myself in this particular capacity is not worth mentioning and giving me what is duly unrightfully mine.
So, from
a political standpoint, the only reason that we don't acknowledge these particular persons is because there is a fear from the backbenchers and the other persons that exist behind the curtains that if you get in this position, you're going to knock my man out.
Okay.
My God, the Free National Movement has to be able to stand firm now and identify strength, identify character, identify vision beyond people telling them what to do. This is a group of men and women that were the freedom fighters of this nation who wanted to get back to the Constitution and found themselves derailed again. Again. And as we try to be able to get back on course again as a nation, as a people, we look at the New Day administration and pray to God that they was back on the rails. So we look at the New Day administration and say, oh God, they went back to their constitution. They made some modification. They did some stuff with aspirants. They're transparent. They did everything. They made modifications in the organization. They got new leadership. My God, this can be the time. This can be the time. And you give them an opportunity and less than three years in, you're saying this is not them.
Okay.
Now we're saying again, as a nation, maybe this kind of a new dispensation and leadership with strength and conviction can be able to emerge again as freedom fighters, 2.0 out of the Free National Movement. And then you look at it and see what's coming to the forefront, and you realize that this council of men and women who are supposed to be the gatekeepers in this country are yet again cowards. Many of them, not all, many of them that are afraid to have a conversation about worth, merit, and value before you promote them. This is relentless social promotion, and we got to deal with it. Talk to me. Is it too much?
Howard.
Is it too much on a Friday?
Howard.
I try to chill out.
Howard, see, you're speaking from your personal understanding, appreciation, and perspective. Your own understanding, your own perspective, your own appreciation. This system that you have identified has worked for both sides of the divide. It has worked. There's only one person in any of those political parties that has a score of 15. Anyone who surpasses 9 is deemed a threat.
You are wild. I like it.
When you reach to 9,
I like it.
You got to ask yourself the question, is this family or is this someone closer than family to get to 10? But when you start getting to 11 and 12, you got to go. Your career is finished based on the person who has 15. Only one person is allowed down 15.
What you're saying to me?
I'm telling you the same thing what the human resources manager said. You will not have a nation of 15 in terms of their character, in terms of their ability, in terms of their effort in the House of Parliament widespread. You have one person with 15, and that 15 that he has, guess what the problem is? The one who has the 15 is only at the level of 8.
That's crazy what you're saying.
So now that he is at 8, that means everybody else at 4. That's the nation why it has not progressed is because we have never gotten past 8.
But you mark it on a scale of 15.
But he, in his mind, said
so
he
you dumbed them down.
You know they dumbed down based on what you see in the country. Show me innovation. Show me ingenuity. Man, I look on Facebook, I see some things around the world happening. I see bridges that are floating across thousands of feet of water. Suspended over water bridges, cars running through a tunnel with fans blowing and keeping oxygen coming through.
I assure you right now that Bahamians, engineer Bahamians can do that.
Right I know now, they can.
Right now.
But you don't want that.
You will never see them though.
Listen.
You ain't gonna pay them, first and foremost.
Even if you doubted them, you can run that same floating bridge across the creeks of Andros and connect every part of Andros. And she would be wide awake. You'd have a wonder beyond wonders. You'd have a landmass in the Bahamas where tourists will flood in. You'll have hotel development. You'll have natural parks. You'll have a smart city. These things can happen. But your leadership is only at the level of 8.
And I think that's you being kind. That's you being kind.
I'm telling you 8 because the rest at 4.
No, that was you being kind. Because there is leadership out of 15... I would give Hubert Ingram, I would give him 11 out of 15. And the additional, because he is at a 15 in the country, and he's recognized from a historic standpoint at a 15 point. But if we look at him, look at his capability, and even his, because this is only a SWOT analysis, even his position to indicate that, okay, well, I am not necessarily the best orator.
That he isn't.
Right? Uh-huh. He'll tell you that.
Yeah.
Yeah. And in so many ways, he says that I'm not necessarily the best orator. Mm-hmm. Forget about that, but let's look at the strategy, look at the approach, and look at the leadership capability. Mm-hmm. So he's at an 11, right? But he's acquired a 15 in this country. You know why?
I'm listening.
You know why? Because the potential that exists in others, they gave it to him. What I use in all of this, Ingram have that, boom, and that has become his political collateral. Well, you know, Ingram, I don't really want to make decisions. I don't want to think. I'll sit here, whatever you tell me to do, I'll do. And they push their collateral amongst him. And that is what gave him these bags and bags and sacks of political collateral in this country. So much so that he could never spend that in 3 lifetimes.
He has a political collateral, you're saying.
That is 15. A scary thing for me.
To me,
that's scary, you know.
To me, I would say no. Because he never utilized that collateral at all to take us as a nation to the 15. You see, for you to be a 15,
but that's
for
why
me,
he's at 11. That's why I tell you.
But you know, but there's some 15
that is the social perception.
Yeah, well, it ain't my perception.
Watch me. Let's be decent. Let me stretch this out properly. He's at an 11 because you know that he's not necessarily the best orator. You know that he's strategic. You know that he's forged relationships. But you also know that he's not cast a significant vision for the country going forward.
That is where I have my situation.
Okay?
Yes.
He hasn't cast a strong enough vision for consistency and commitment in these particular areas. But he retains those positions and he retains those sacks of collateral, those political collateral. You know why? Because he continues to use it behind the scenes. Right now. Right now, within the FNM and the PLP. This Papa. Papa could still be able to manipulate a specific course because of the collateral that he owes. And that has been given to him by men who wish not to think.
Let me ask you a question, Howard.
By men who wish not to try.
Let me test your
who opinion. Are afraid to lose their position and their post of just being close to proximity of leadership because they open up their mouth. And so they would say nothing. And they would give you their talents. They say, no, man, you can use that. That's what's happening again. It needs to stop happening.
Let me give you a
simple challenge. You have to rise and fall on your own top, on your bottom.
Simple challenge for you, Howard. Before you moved from your residence, you moved to a new residence, but where you lived initially, do you see that as one of the fastest growing areas in New Providence?
West Nassau?
Yeah.
Yes, it is.
Good. Was there a huge land clearing?
Yes.
There was. Here's a pivotal question for you. Do you see the establishment of a school for those thousands of children that have to use buses every morning?
Private. I haven't seen it. I haven't heard anything public.
So what prevents a great leader from establishing a school in that side of the island?
Vision.
That's all I'm talking about. Simple vision. Nothing grand. Just simple. I should build no bridge across the ocean. I just ask you to put the right facility in the right places. Listen, if Carmichael Road is growing by leaps and bounds every day, and I have to watch the children jump on buses just to get to Anatole Rogers, that's crazy.
Or Garvin Times.
That's crazy. Or Gerald Cash. That's crazy. Children. Have to do that.
We knew that leadership lacks vision overarchingly. And when I get back, because I got to take this commercial break, when I get back, I'd like to have a good conversation with you about, you know, I don't know if you had an opportunity to be able to listen in, but former Prime Minister Minnis spoke last night, and he was transparent about a great deal of things. I think on Monday, I got to stretch this whole thing out far and wide to talk about this because it was peculiar to me. It was peculiar, his honesty and vulnerability. And then I asked myself whether or not this is
genuine.
Not only genuine, that for some reason he understands what this dispensation requires of him.
He does? Yeah. Now?
No, not just now. Not just now.
So we're missing something.
Oh, yeah, okay, watch it.
When you come back?
The Bahamian people uh-huh. are very sensitive.
Extremely.
Yeah, and we are thin-skinned.
Very much so.
From a political standpoint.
Oh, yeah.
We are extremely offended and very easily offended.
Yes.
But we're also open enough to be able to hear your apology, accept it, and move forward.
There was an apology?
You should watch the thing.
I couldn't.
But you can't. You still got a chance.
Yeah, I know. You'll share it with me.
Yeah, I can share it with
you. I worked too hard yesterday.
It was exhausting.
I actually was one of the behemoths.
Did you like open up your mouth when the honey was dropping? This is a lot. Let me take this quick commercial break, ladies and gentlemen. Quick commercial break and be right back after this.
The foundation. The foundation. The foundation. The foundation.
foundation. The foundation.
Tired of banks forcing you to use technology to bank the way they want you to? Your convenience is important. So no matter what your banking needs, Commonwealth Bank's friendly staff are always available in branch for that personal one-on-one service. But when you choose technology, our online and mobile banking app offers you state-of-the-art functionality. The choice is yours. Commonwealth Bank. Bank the way you want.
Calling all pizza lovers. Craving something extraordinary? Head into Marco's Pizza and try our golden crust deep dish pizza. Made thick and delicious with fresh dough, fresh cheese, and fresh sauce. And baked to perfection with your toppings of choice. No one makes pizza quite as good as we do. Enjoy all this goodness for $14.75 only at Marco's Pizza. Make the right choice and order Marco's at marcospizzabahamas.com.
Bonneville Bones, established in 1970, is the leader in men's fashion in the Bahamas. We're conveniently located in the Mall at Marathon and the Harbor Bay Shopping Plaza, and fully stocked with everything you need for all occasions. Our Harbor Bay location is one door north of Alive, with the black and white signage of Bonneville Boutique. Both locations are open from 10 to 7 p.m. Monday through Saturday. Bonneville Bones and Bonneville Boutique, still the leader in men's fashion. Located in the Mall at Marathon and the Harbor Bay Shopping Plaza.
It's a special day for mom and she deserves the best. Bring her into Baja and let's de-stress. We'll pamper her and make her feel safe. Get mom a nice spa day.
Come visit us at Baja Retreat Spa. Purchase a gift for mom. And call us today at 323-6711.
Pamper her and make her feel safe. Get mom a nice spa day.
For fast, reliable, and impactful printing services, look no further. Let Printmasters bring your masterpiece to life. We stand by our quality products that is second to none. Our affordable pricing and friendly, efficient staff makes Printmasters the ultimate choice for all your printing needs. We can deliver any type of printing services, from banners to booklets to business cards. You name it, we can print it.
Let Printmasters bring your masterpiece to life.
Located in the Nassau Guardian Building, telephone 302-2361.
Foundation. Foundation.
And we are back, ladies and gentlemen, 96.9 FM radio, Howard Grant and your company, The Foundation. We're here with none other than Garth at the 1:30 mark. We're going to be able to bring in direct marketers to have some good conversation with you and also start to give you sort of a shout out. We got to go take a hail Chantel this weekend over at Coco Plum Bistro. Coco Plum Bistro, we're going to be able to hang out with her on Sunday for Mother's Day. So we are excited for that, guys. If you want to be able to make your, you know, your reservations for that. She said that she's booked, absolutely booked. I called her and find out, Jesus, I shouldn't have said that on the radio. Now my wife knows that we get a little something we can be able to do. Well, I told her. So we're going to be able to enjoy ourselves with Coco Plum Bistro. But I just want to kind of make sense of what we're saying. Howard, you're an idealist. Howard, you're living in la-la land. Howard, this is not how things are. Forget integrity, forget conviction, forget strength, and understand that you have to play the game to get to your objective, right? So whatever that means, men are willing to take that chance. Howard, talking too much. You're talking too much about these particular things. Let's just be, yes. Somebody say direct marketers on a Friday, Howard? Yes. I gave him an opportunity to be able to come here. Don't fight me, right? So, I want to talk, man. I want to talk with you guys and talk about these things. Garth, we're here, and I want to just kind of make sense of this. Let's just be decent as possible, right? Let's be decent as we structure this and move towards what we have to, right? Let's be decent, right? The fact of the matter is, all I'm seeing is as I look at not only the Free National Movement, as I look at politics in the country, as I look at political, right? The state of politics in the country, and I identify that men are losing their character, their caliber, their position, their convictions, the ideas, the visions that they have to be able to contribute to politics and how they can move the country forward. They are losing that just for an opportunity to present them their face. I was called by ZNS. I told you this before. To come and sit on ZNS. He said, come sit on ZNS. It's a great opportunity.
You've been there before.
I've been there before, right?
How was it when you were there?
I thought it was good until I brought on an opposing government, right?
You're not supposed to do that?
The royal opposition, right?
Is that a hidden rule?
It's an unspoken rule.
Unspoken.
Right.
But you're supposed to know
not
that.
It's not the constitution of the organization. It's not the strength of the organization. It's not the mission, the overarching objective of the organization. It's an unspoken rule that, you know what they say? I take directives. How would I take directives, you know? These men and women have...
So you're talking...
When I was there, they had no conviction.
So you're talking about petty politics.
This is what happens.
There's no democracy.
So I left ZNS, and now a new government's in, and I had a couple conversations, and... Howard, would you consider? By some old folks who, older men, statesmen, who I hold in extremely high regard, asked me, Howard, would you return to ZNS?
Uh-huh.
And I said, no. They say, why? Howard, you have a young family. They always try to tell you what you have, right? Howard, you have a young family. I didn't know this. Thanks, sir, right? Howard, you got a young family. You got to take care of your bills. You got to do this. You got to do that. You got a lot of children. Your children getting off to school. ZNS could be able to help you. Boom, 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 boom. Go to ZNS. If I go to ZNS, all I would be is a fat red man. That's it. You will see Howard Grant's face, but never hear my character, my substance, my voice, my nothing. And all for a position to acquire something to give you the perception in your mind that I got something. And I lost myself entirely. That is what these men have become in politics. Everything. They lose everything for the idea to retain a position of leadership. And they sit in the position of leadership, and everything that they ever stood for, they have to put that aside. They have to put it aside.
So Howard, you touch a nerve with me, though. You touch a nerve. The nerve that you touch with me before you go to your lines... for 4 years, your citizenry has character, integrity, faith, expertise, intelligence. But on the fifth year, election year, we give all of that to a politician based on a color or based on our own loyalties to that particular entity. Does that sound familiar to you?
It's the same thing. It's no different.
So the politicians are only reflections, or they are part and parcel of the very citizenry that they came from. We're the same.
It may be one and the same, but everyone's not the same.
Not everyone, but largely so. It is.
But that only exists. Okay, so let's do this.
I'm talking about a culture now, Howard.
Now let's do this.
I'm talking about a culture.
We didn't get 2 seconds.
Because you're talking about changing the narrative in terms of the way our politicians should be. They should be transparent. They should be honest. They should be able to contribute during their time in Parliament. They should be able to bring vision to the table. Yes, I hear all of that. But they're coming from the same people who give away all of those gifts and attributes during the electoral process.
During the Burma Road riot, who were we as a people? During independence, who were we as a people?
But who were our political leaders then?
Right. And these are the strength. And their strength was a representation of the strength of the community. And after leadership came in and started to slowly morph the minds of people and said, take the idea from your strength and press it on, give it to the PLP. Render your strengths, your convictions, your visions to the PLP. We will take these things and be able to craft the Bahamas that you desire, that you envision, that we're doing all the heavy lifting, that we will wipe every tear from every eye. That's the marketing. That was the marketing of this particular time.
Howard, you go in deep.
Men, and of course, there's no other way to
Howard,
do this.
I know I'm getting on here soon.
There's ain't no other way to do this.
So let me baptize you today.
The PLP has introduced this idea of rendering your convictions and the ideas of what needs to happen that you believe should happen for the country,
Howard,
and render it to the altar of the PLP. The FNM understood that, forged an organization and said that we are the freedom fighters, that for our ideas, for the vision, for the constitution of the organization, we will revive these aspects and ideas. And they took their the same talents that they had, Because all of us start at 15, and they render it onto the altar of not only the FNM, but to the leadership of an FNM.
Oh, come you on, got me in trouble. Talk. But I'm in trouble now.
Let's talk.
You know, you just got me in trouble.
Everybody in trouble.
Okay, so.
All
so,
us.
So let me tell you why. You see, you
caused me to go. Let me take this call, because that's you. See, you're talking about that.
Go ahead. Take the call. No, let me
go
say
ahead.
I gotta say.
Go ahead, go ahead.
No,
go
no,
ahead.
Take the call.
Go ahead, call her. Call her, go ahead.
Yes, hello, good afternoon.
Hey, good afternoon. Hey. Who's this?
What's happening, God? What's happening, Howard?
Doing good.
Good. So, we in trouble.
This minute.
Because
this Atlanta.
When you look at the power grid, it's not only generation, it's also infrastructure. You cannot put on new clothes if you ain't bathed.
They do it all the time.
Well, okay? Technically, you shouldn't.
They do it all the time.
So,
touch the skin and don't wash the bottom of your foot.
Okay? And let's talk about this leadership thing and vision. If the populace would hold people accountable for what they don't do, then they would be more apt to change. But if the people still looking for what they could get temporarily, why change? So right now we're looking at a very intricate problem because the mindset and the paradigm remains the same.
That's crazy. That is,
crazy.
That is crazy. Yeah. And that's unfortunate.
Y'all have a good day.
I appreciate your telephone call.
Now, this is why you all took me deep. And Smitty, I want you to listen to this clearly to me now. The very same culture that you just explained to me, I'll tell you where they got it from. This whole idea of the political party being the all in all, the one who
that's where you put your talents.
Okay, so what?
To enter the halls, put your talents here.
Okay, watch this now. Every Saturday and every Sunday, the very same activity and action you just spoke about happens in your church. Bring your talent, bring your time, and bring your money.
And
hold on, and leave it here at the altar. And when you ask the average Bahamian, what does your pastor do with the money? You know what they say? Oh, you don't question the man of God. You don't disrespect the man of God. Whatever they decide to do with it, that's on them. God can deal with them. The same attitude in politics. Bring all your children. Guess what? You know how much people children go before these politicians and are molested and no one says anything? Why? Allegedly. I should use allegedly, eh? But they go there, right, for job. And they got to do all type of little tricks and somersaults. And you know where the definition of this is found? Read your Bible. The same Bible you put your own throat, God.
That's
read
what the Levites, that. That's what the Levites did.
It says in the Bible, so if you want a king, remember they was asking for a king? They said, well, we want a king. He said, if you want a king, the king can take the best of your wives, the best of your daughters, the best of your sheep, the they best said, of your goats, the best of your house, best of everything.
They said, that's okay.
Isn't this what we now see in Bahamian politics?
That's okay.
We bring everything to them. And let them have it, and we don't question. That's why there's no transparency, and there's no Freedom of Information Act, and there's nothing for you, and everything for them. It's the same thing with your pastor, man. You're giving them everything. I always said, I ain't going to say this, and then I'm going home. You control rocking me later. I don't know how everybody could go to one building on the weekend, and only one man leave with money. I don't understand. I call that robbery. Now, you got to check yourself, man. If the pastors are not in the community when you have these violent crimes, and going to go pray with people, and touch people's lives, and talk to children, and help mentor your sons, and mentor your daughters, and fix your broken marriages. Too much divorce.
But you know,
too much things happen in our society.
I understand.
And the politician is only one side of society.
Let's be
but
clear.
The preachers, you the other side, are supposed to balance this and make sure we have healthy communities in this country called the Commonwealth of the Bahamas.
Now, understand something. Let's
you
got to
wait for your money, man.
When they present themselves in these constituencies, they have ideas for development and this and that, the next thing. And as soon as they acquire that position, they have to now put that talent, that idea, that vision, that goal, the aspirations. They have
15.
To put that at the altar of their political organization.
To
and adhere to whatever the overarching objective is for that organization and never get back to the community.
That's why can't be no MP.
That is why they get off and on, so forth and so on.
Yes.
And demonize anyone who commits themselves to the constituency. Oh, this one has gone contrary. Let's take a telephone call before we get out of here. Caller, go ahead. Go ahead, caller.
Yes, Mr. Grant, how are you?
I'm good, man. What's happening?
Not bad. Mr. Grant, I hear you talk about the Progressive Party of the Bahamas, right? But how could you call yourself progressive and privatize and, I mean, BPL, man? How?
Because they've never, we haven't identified what is progression in this country.
Progressive is to work on behalf of the masses, man.
Well, if the PLP has come to us and indicated that this is progressive and this is what we're doing on behalf of the masses, the many of us got accepted.
That's it.
Progressive to them means aggressive. You know, that's the oars and me baby thing again. No one saying nothing, man.
Only those of us who have eyes to be able to see and a mouth to articulate can be able to say that this is not progressive, that it lacks innovation, that it lacks creativity, that it lacks inclusion of the people who have ideas for our community for growth and development. I appreciate your telephone call. Let me take the next one. Caller on the line with us live. Go ahead. Go ahead, callers. Guys, the lines are wide open. 323-6232-325-4316-325-4259. Anywhere from the family of violence, 242-300-5720-422-4796. Caller. Go ahead, caller. Caller on the line with us live. Go ahead. Go ahead, caller.
Hey, good day, Howard.
Hey, what's up, baby?
That's all good.
Good day, God.
Hey, my lovely lady. How you doing?
Oh, I just have to take my pressure pills one time to listen to you. I just love
you. Man, you use something. What they call it, the pear leaf or something. Pear leaf or what, a sour sob leaf?
Yeah. don't use fever gas if your thing will go up higher.
You talk with so much passion.
Yeah, it's getting hot sometimes. I'm sorry.
It literally riles me up. You know, and then when Howard comes with his little twist.
Yeah, but Howard heavy, you know. I got to try and lift him. I got to try and make him, you know, go off. That's my job. I stick him.
He has a diplomatic way of trying to say something bad.
I try.
He won't be decent.
No, I see. These men smart, you know.
But, you know, listening to you guys talking, just now, it came to mind when you were talking about what we accept. If you look at the government system, the entire workforce of the government system, you notice that the MPs work the same way as a new worker work in the government system. They come in with they enthusiastic, they ready to work, they passionate because they just got this new job and they're all hyped up.
I love
and it. 2 weeks in, and they sit one lunch day with the old workers, and all of that is flat out of the door.
Thank you very much. They're in charge.
That's the way the MPs work. They go in enthusiastic, and when they get that one lunch date and see where, hold on now, y'all trying to make me look bad, that ain't gonna happen. So this is the line to follow. All enthusiastic just fly out of the door like a low tide.
We gotta fix that in this country. I appreciate your telephone call, my dear. Thank you so very kindly for being able to do that. We gotta fix that in this country. It has to be the strength of the Bahamian people stepping forward and being able to speak with strength. Loud. And conviction to be able to move forward. Let me take two more calls before we get out of here. Caller, go ahead. Caller, you on the line with us live. Go ahead. Hello?
Hello?
Hey.
Alan?
Hey, what's up, Anton? Go ahead.
Hold on a second. Y'all can hear me?
Yeah, Anton, go ahead.
I thought it sounded loaded there. What happened?
Yeah, I don't know. I've been holding on so long, I thought I was in space. Anyway, good afternoon, Howard and God.
What you say?
Good afternoon.
Don't let no one else hold on after you now. We only got 5 minutes. What you got to say?
Yeah, I've been holding on for 2 hours. But anyway, Howard, I see you carrying on a conversation that we began maybe 2 weeks ago, where I made a statement regarding Pintard and Menace and the leadership race, and stating if we want to see real change, The leader coming out of their camp is going to have to be someone who stands on his own 2 feet, right? That is critical. If you note what the former prime minister ministered in Abaco, he stated that the Ingram era was over, right? And that I believe that was a defining point for him to create separation between his leadership and minister leadership, which was absolute, and Ingram's leadership, which was absolutely necessary in order for him to be respected.
He spoke to that last night. He spoke to that.
And for his vision, to be able to be seen as his vision and not anyone else's vision, similar to a ventriloquist pulling the words out of his mouth, but from behind the scenes. Let me make a comment on this Ingram barometer that you created, Howard. You said you gave Ingram an 11, you created a barometer of 15 and you gave him an 11 nationwide and a 15 otherwise. Well, I have a tendency to disagree with you on that. I give Ingram within the F&M fold a 15, but countrywide I give Ingram a 7 or 8. The reason being, because yes, he would have done some great things, right, Howard, and God and the nation, but if you examine more closely the price that this country has paid for those things that he was able to do, the price it far outweighs negatively what we have gained positively, starting back from Atlantis. Atlantis is similar to the port, except Atlantis is performing better than the port. But if you look at what we have given Atlantis and what they have gained over the decade versus the mere jobs that we receive as a benefit and taxes, it really doesn't add up. If you look at the performance in good times and the performance in bad times, and you analyze the benefits remaining consistent, irregardless of the times, we are really not getting our value for money as a country. If you look at, if you conduct that same analysis, Howard, over all of the good things that has been done in this country, we are still large and in part living off of the benefits of the infrastructure and the works that the original Pinlin government put in place in this country. We are not far removed from it. However, if you look at the implementation of the Bahama project,
Let's finish this conversation on Monday. I can call you and reach out to you. I want to finish this conversation on Monday because I believe wholeheartedly that Ingram represented a second dispensation, a 2.0 for infrastructural development in a time that the country needed it, in a time where the world was moving forward, and he understood, because he understands infrastructure, and he understood that the city needed to be prepared to move in this particular dispensation. So I'd like to kind of finish that conversation and strengthen that out as we continue to talk forward. Garth, I want to thank you so much for being able to join me today, my brother. I know that it's been a very quick one, but I'm grateful that you can be able to sit here with me and talk about these things, my brother.
Hey, man, it's been a pleasure. You know, they've been following me and asking why you like Howard so much. They don't see me on TV no more. I said, man, this is not only the foundation. This is the real conversation. So I look forward to seeing you again next week. Be safe, Bahamas, and God bless.
Guys, quick commercial break. Be right back after this.
Why settle for an ordinary burger when you can indulge in the new Farmhouse King at Burger King Nassau? Sink your teeth into two juicy flame-grilled beef patties piled high with crisp bacon, American cheese, crispy onions, a fried egg, and a spicy mayo sauce that adds bold flavor to every bite. Enjoy the new Farmhouse King as a combo with fries and a drink, or if you're feeling extra hungry, try the King's Feast, available exclusively at Burger King Nassau.
BWF wishes all mothers a happy Mother's Day. As we celebrate you, mothers wear many hats. For these hats, we say thank you for your unconditional love, commitment, sacrifices, and dedication. Pamper your mother with love this Mother's Day with a gift from BWF during our 2 weeks of Mother's Day savings, up to 40% off Monday, April 29th through Saturday, May 11th. Savings include appliances, kitchen and outdoor cooking supplies, houseware supplies, bath towel gift sets, quilts, comforters and sheet sets, curtains, floral decor, and much, much more. Open Monday through Friday, 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. and Saturday, 8 a.m. to 1 p.m. BWF, we are more than just our name. Number 13 Wilton Street, telephone 394-0004 or 6. Check us out on Facebook. We ship to the Family Islands.
With boss man was saying in the back there just now.
About what? The luncheon?
Why are you always worried about food? No. About how we gotta pay a little more for national insurance.
Mildred, you talking fool.
I can't afford to pay that. And you're always crying, palm out. Ain't gonna be much. Boss still got to pay. 1st of July, 2024.
I think that terminal benefit is what did help my boy Tony through the pandemic. Oh. That same unemployment benefit.
And guess what?
What?
Susan, I think she'd get a pregnancy benefit, eh?
You mean maternity benefit, eh? So now, we got to do our part to make sure we get our pension. All right.
For more information, visit NIPRateIncrease.com.
John Bull presents its annual Mother's Day Garden Party. Shop new spring collection for her. Redefine your style. Find inspiration as you browse this season's standout. Be entertained. Special live art and music feature with Preston Hanna and DJ Super Mario. There will be photo keepsakes, gift personalization, perfume engraving, and henna. There's a spring style show. Dress in your season's best. Sign up for their spring fashion walk in store for a chance to win a $500 gift card. Scope out the latest scents and makeup trends. There will be in-store raffles, gifts with purchase, and gourmet bites and beverages. Indulge in sweet delights. That's Saturday, May 11th, 11 a.m. to 5 p.m. at John Bull 284 Bay Street. That's John Bull's annual Mother's Day Garden Party, hosted by the Natural Empress.
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
Nah, saw a real boy. Nah, saw ain't no real place. I say, nah, saw a real boy. Nah, saw ain't no real place.
Born in Camp Road, man, I straight off the block. Great on TikTok, every word that I talk. In the Beamer, screaming, I'm waking them up. Total shock, I can rock.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. 96.9 FM radio. Every time this man come in here, he keep talking about NASA in a real place. I'm sure he write this song. He ain't gonna tell me about it.
Yes.
In the studio with me is none other than Ian Thomas, all the way from Direct Market, is talking to us about these things. Now, y'all don't fight me now. Mother's Day is coming up. Y'all ain't in call me. Y'all don't want to talk politics. You ain't even talk with your mother. I give y'all an opportunity to talk with your mother. I say, text in. Tell me about your mom. Yeah, well, tell me about your mother. Yeah, well, say shout out to her mother. So forth and so on. But it's a very important thing that we understand that we're transitioning into a weekend where we have to be able to identify our mother. And have to be. I think many of us do that on a day-to-day basis. But to be able to acknowledge her commitment, acknowledge all those particular things, and give her an opportunity to kick back is what we're going to do here today. So the last 30 minutes of the show, I'd like to be able to talk about opportunities that are available for persons to be able to go out there and share with their mother. Ian, say good afternoon to people out there.
Good afternoon, people out there.
Should I tell you everything to say?
I swear. Hey, listen here, man, Howard. I am so happy to be here today. I know individuals are expecting you guys to have this open dialogue and talk about politics and all that stuff, but it's Mother's Day, and I get to jump right in here and say a few things for Mom's Day. So I come here to tell you about your ma. We're together. What happened?
You come to tell me about my mom? I don't think they have the same connotations that you want to.
I know.
That's a different connotation entirely.
I was driving here. I got in somebody's lane. They tell me my ma. So.
Okay.
So it's Mother's Day. HSS Electrical. How are they located? SHSS Electrical. They're located on Chesapeake Road. And the phone number there is 605-7777. They're doing something really, really big for Mother's Day. I want you guys to go in there, and between now and tomorrow, I'm going to let someone have a chance to win, you know, those surrounding lights around your house, those flood from security lights. Go down there and check them out. Right now, for the remaining time of the month, that you can get those 2x4 feet LED flat panel lights. They were $99. You can get them for $77. You can get the 2x2, that's 2 feet by 2 feet, LED flat panel lights. They, pardon me, they were $65, now $42.90. You can get the 4 foot universal LED bulbs. They were $15, now just $6.60. That's an incredible savings down there that they're having at SHSS. Also, Dusk to Dawn, say it again. How are we looking? Bring it down? Bring it down. Bring it down. Bring the mic down, Ian. Okay, then, those Dusk to Dawn LED floodlights with the bulbs, they were $50, now $22. And all the Square D products you're looking for, like they got the Square D main breaker meter combo. That's, it has 8 spaces, 16 circuit surface mount. That's available right now, 150 amps and 200 amps, now starting at a low $350. Like I said, other places I saw them for going as high as $500. And once you go down there and you check out everything that they have to offer down there. Like others, like, oh, wait a second. They also want me to mention, they have, like I said, they have all the Square D products. You can get switches, combos, breaker panels, electrical wires, meter cans. All that is right down there. Like I said, LED bulbs in all the sizes that you want. We're going to give away something this weekend, the LED, not LED, away the motion sensor light for around the house. You come in there, sign up, tell me you want to get something for your mom, and we're going to do something crazy down there. The phone number is 605-7777, 605-7777. You want to do something special for your mom this Mother's Day. SS Electrical to get everything she needs for all the lights around the house. They even have a few ceiling fans. I think it's made by Hunter, if I'm not mistaken. And you go in and check them out. Where are they located? They're located in Chesapeake, in the former Minute Muffler building, and you want to go there. So it's no need to go to Miami or order anything from Miami. You want to order right here locally at SHSS Electrical. I have two electricians, as a matter of fact, and they both tell me they use SHSS Electrical. So, hey, kudos to you guys over there at SHSS Electrical. That's the Store family. Everyone knows them from Henry F. Store. They're no longer operating in that building on Mackey Street. They moved to that new building I just spoke about, the former Minute Muffler on Chesapeake Road. Last time, SHSS Electrical, the phone number 605-77, that's 605. So that is an incredible thing happening over there at SHSS Electrical. Hey, Howard, you know what I forgot to do?
I
forgot to be recording this, you know. We were supposed to be recording this.
Sir, we're on the radio. Everything's recorded.
Yeah, but I mean, I got to go back and I got to wait till
name is. I'll send it to you today.
Uploaded. No, Howard, you won't get this today, man. Don't try that, man.
You wasting your time. Let's go.
Man. You're just making me mad. It's still Mother's Day. Howard, EcoFlow Delta Pro. That's the portable generator that we spoke about. I had like about 70 calls this weekend about those. If you are being at the mercy of those blackouts when that happened, turn this phone off. If you guys are tired of being at the mercy of the power company, I want you guys to get yourself a generator. And I'm not talking about one of those big generators that cost you thousands and thousands of dollars. I'm talking about the portable generator by EcoFlow Delta Pro. The phone number is 327-4504. I'm sure you heard me speak about it many times here. The number is 327-4504. They are sold under the under the parent company, JS Steel. So it can make the power, power outages a thing of the past. What I like about them is that the device, it has the capacity to accommodate 15 devices. So you can plug in your phone, your fan, your television, your microwave, and in some cases, even your air condition. So it has 15 spots to plug in. It also has a AC port, two DC ports with a 30-amp output. And a car output. So you individuals who are living on the family island, there's no need to be sweating and hot and tired and bothered when the electricity goes out. Even you individuals living here in Nassau, that's EcoFlow by Delta Pro. It's a portable generator. You don't have to be rich anymore. The phone number is 327-4504. 327-4504. 327-4504. Ask for Jennifer or Sean or George. They're doing an incredible job down there. Their prices start as low as $335 all the way up to $4,224. That's VAT included. And you can get this portable generator that you can carry any place that you want to go. And another thing what I've learned about them is that the battery that operates it, it's the same battery that Tesla uses, the same technology. So you know you have a credible, strong battery that's long-lasting, and it's going to be able to give you the power that you need. So you want a portable generator, give them a call right now. Like I said, you don't have to be rich. Prices as low as $335 up to $4,224. You individuals who have a solar panels, you can plug it straight into your solar panel. Get the battery charged up in your EcoFlow Delta Pro. Keep the battery charged, and you can even turn off your main power and just run your whole building, your apartment, your house, your business with it. You want more information? Give them a call at 327-4504, 327-4504. They didn't tell me this, but I'm going to see if we can try to give away one of these devices.
And do things that the people ain't tell you to do.
Say again?
You want to know?
No, I'm not telling them. I'm saying I'm going to ask them in the future if we can do it. In the future, I'm going to ask them if we can give away a device because so many people have been calling, not just here locally.
I told you, let me beta test it.
But as a matter of fact, I got
I
one.
I told at, you, let me beta
I got
test
one at
it.
Home, and I'm beta testing it. And I beta
you tasting it?
No, beta testing
yeah,
it.
Yeah, you should
beta
be
testing it. The hell out of it. VHS testing it. I was some making me say stupidness. But
go ahead.
Your mind is wonderful. That's EcoFlow Delta Pro, the portable generator. It's a wonderful thing. It doesn't just, it's not just a generator. It changes your whole life. Now you have power, and they're expecting a serious hurricane season this year. So you know what that means. You got to be prepared with all those things, including a generator. 327-4504. 327-4504.
Yeah.
Now, Howard, my pharmacy of choice, you know it, Centerville Pharmacy. I always talk about that. They want to tell everybody and wish all the women and mothers and grandmothers and aunts and
we
all these different
places.
We
spoke about this one time.
Yep,
you telling
yep,
me something
yep.
about a
they want to say happy.
Like
what?
Yeah, go ahead.
Say Plan B. Well, John, you must have been planning. You must have been using Plan A.
Go ahead, sir. Go ahead. I'm going to fight you.
One more child, you're going to have a hockey team.
Well, please tell the people what you
and
said
listen,
to me yesterday. Huh?
Pharmacy,
tell the people what you said to me yesterday.
What I say, when I'm going to crochet.
Anyway, don't tell him. Go ahead. You can't say
that
because you're indecent.
It's indecent.
If you can text
it's
it.
It's indecent, but it's not indecent.
It is absolutely indecent.
No, it's not. It's not indecent. It's, come on, man. Think about it. It's not indecent, especially how you say it. It's not just what you say. It's how you say it.
Praise God. I'm not going to fight you. Go ahead with the Centerville.
So this is Centerville Pharmacy. This is the number one place you want to go to get all your prescriptions filled quick and easily. Especially if you guys are going to go ahead your medication order. The process is even much, much faster. You want to go down there and check them out. If you have a mobility problem, that's no problem with them. They come outside and they hand deliver you everything right up there. I guess that's called curbside
delivery.
Curbside
hand delivery. Is there any other way that they give it to you?
No, they say here. Yeah,
can they give it to you with your feet?
And just chuck it at you.
Hands,
here, take that.
Hands. Go ahead, sir. Go ahead.
So that's no problem. So if you want over-the-counter meds to make you feel better, Centerville Pharmacy carries 7 C's and Haloborange. I know I could say
Haloborange.
Haloborange, yeah.
Okay, good, good.
It builds your immune system. You know that, Howard?
Yeah, I do.
Okay.
Good. My children take that.
Oh, that's really good. Okay,
and their
good.
Immune system is really built.
Oh, that's
and
good.
Also their energy is really built.
Yeah, I get it. They get it from their daddy, man. Come on, man.
She
so they also have brands like Good Sense. That's excellent for getting your zinc intake. And you can also get all the meds.
They texted me. They say, Howard, we can't hear
price.
Ian. He's not
speaking into
fix
the mic.
You can't hear.
Come on,
mic.
Man.
Okay, go ahead. Speak
okay,
directly
let me
into
put
the
this
mic.
In front of me. Okay, then. Here we go. You can also use your national prescription drug plan.
You didn't have to slow down your
card.
Speech, sir.
That entitles you, entitles even more discounts. So if you want a pharmacy that cares about your entire family, I want you to visit any one of their three locations. First one is on Collins Avenue, opposite the Heart Center. The next one's on Mackey and Wilton Street, across from Topps Lumber Yard. Akron Center now, that's the one that I go to all the time. Shout out to my good doctor. Anyway, I don't have to call his name out. So that's on Rosetta Street, that's opposite the Old Starbucks. I love going to Centerville Pharmacy, and you will love too. It's a family-owned company, and they're doing an incredible job over there. It's the Albrechts family, and man, hey, I just love them so much. So go there. They want to let everyone know in the entire Bahamas, have yourself a great Mother's Day, and they're going to continue doing what they do and making everyone's process of getting their medication so much easier. So that is an incredible thing. Howard, you just moved into your new home. Are you doing any painting?
You know, all this painting is done.
Oh, the painting's done? Well, if you're not like Howard and you need some painting done, you know what, you didn't get it done during the Christmas time, or you know what, you need a little bit of touch up and all that good stuff, this is a great time to go down to the Paint Depot. They got the flat white interior exterior paint, 1 gallon, VAT included, for $30, or you get the gallon for $125, VAT included. Now, this is while supplies last. The phone number there is 6326-
I need some stuff. I'm going to lie. The back wall I won't paint. I need some.
Yeah, you need that.
I need some 1-2-3 primer. Right?
I just finished buying that.
I need some 1-2-3 primer. And I need some oil paint for the tongue and groove and one of the, I got a like a Nassau style thing.
Yeah.
It's really nice. I won't paint it over
there. Go down there, check it out, let them know that, hey, listen, I'm there with Ian and about you guys.
Excuse me. You just need to call them.
I'll make a phone call.
Praise God.
Ms. Johnson, Howard, come in. The phone number down there for the Paint Depot is 326-1875. 326-1875. You can WhatsApp them at 5878-823-5878. Where they're located? They're located right there in number 151 Mount Royal Avenue. You can check them out on Facebook and Instagram as well. What I like what they're doing right now is that you can enter to win their Mother's Day promotion. That's where you can submit a photo of you and your mom to their Facebook. That's www.facebook.com/paintdepot. Send a photo of you and your mom, a wonderful picture of you two together, and win yourself a grand prize of $250. That's worth of an in-store credit. So go check them out. That's the Paint Depot, and they are located on Mount Royal Avenue, number 151 Mount Royal Avenue. Get all the paints you need. $30 for the white interior exterior paint, and $125 for the 5 gallon of that. And this is for while supplies last. Go and check them out. Send a photo of you and your mom for that promotion.
My mother's texting me now. She's in Jacksonville.
Yeah.
She's up there with my aunt and my
cousin.
That'll
be weird if you send your
She texts me. She said, what did he say about my crochet? I'm going to text her. I'm going to text her the indecency of what you said.
Ma'am, what had happened was somebody had hacked my WhatsApp.
I told them you love to crochet, mommy. Right?
Yes.
And he texts me some stuff. I'm going to send it to you right now.
Yes.
Go ahead.
Hey, Howard, where are you going to go eat this weekend?
I am... Well, honestly, I've set some stuff up to actually go to with my wife on Monday, on
Where you
Sunday.
Go ahead, tell me.
I'm going to Coco Plum Bistro.
That sounds good.
Right.
So, everyone, you need to
However,
be
I have 8 stomachs to fill.
Yes.
So, the weekend could be extremely long.
The weekend could be
we
long.
We could go Saturday and Sunday.
You can go Saturday and Sunday.
Okay,
so, one of those
tell me
days,
where we're going now.
Howard is going to go and take his wife to the poop deck. And which one are you going to go to?
To the
Sandy Port. Very good. Right. Sandy Port. Write the phone number down for Sandy Port Poop Deck. 327-3325. 327-3325. 327-3325. That's the Poop Deck. And go check them out. That's at Sandy Port.
No, I will go to this place for real. You know what? I haven't been here in years. In fact, the last time I went with my uncle.
Oh.
I went with my mother. This is right after she won. This is all the way back in 2007. That's the last time I've been there.
Howard.
And I haven't really been there since.
Howard, I want
and so
you
I'd
to
like
really
to be able to see the experience.
I want you to go there. Do you want to know what's on the menu?
Tell the boss,
or do you want to keep on rambling on?
Oh, I'm sorry, sir. I won't ramble.
Mother's Day.
Go ahead.
Mother's Day. They have a 3-course meal. Now, this is for the appetizer. Conky Joe Chowder. So that's some conky Joe Chowder? Conky Joe Chowder.
They should do some browning on the conk.
Don't be racist. They have creamy Caribbean conch chowder, slowly simmered with chunks of vegetables. Entrees, your choice. Chicken, New Providence. That's $42.75. You can get a boneless breast of chicken rolled in a traditional stuffing, served with garlic mashed potatoes, topped with sauce, New Providence sauce, of course. That's their special blend. Served with sweet plantains. You like plantains or plantains?
I don't know the difference between plantains, but I don't think I've ever had
it's
a plantain.
I know.
I've never had a plantain, sir.
Well, that's for $42.75.
I don't go to America and get those things.
Give me some plantains.
No. What is a plantain?
Boy, I know
platin.
What if you were planting?
That is delicious.
Plantains? What if you were planting plantains?
I don't think they will grow.
Anyway, let me go on this one. That first one was $42.75. The Natter one is the grouper poop deck. That's for $62.75. Filet of grouper.
You know which poop deck I've been to?
Which one?
I've been to the poop deck out east. My wife and I.
Didn't go to that one.
We went there. But I'm saying I've never been to the one out west.
That's right. You're
saying
but the west one.
Okay, good.
You want to tell me but the east one? I'll tell you what happened in the west.
Okay, I'm not going to.
So, we're on the group enough.
I know the west is the best.
The west is the best. Listen.
Okay,
the group enough. Listen, Howard. Listen. Filet of grouper. Pan-seared stuffed with seafood stuffing. Mm-mm. Served with peas and rice. And steamed vegetables. That's for $62.75. Now you get into the minced lobster. Listen, this is $64.75. Bahamian minced lobster, seasoned with herbs and spices, served with basmati, white rice, and coleslaw. You like that? That's $64.75. Now this is the last one. Mini rack of lamb, $68.75. Served with garlic, served with 4-bone grilled mini rack of lamb. And this ain't no little small rack, you know, big, meaty, juicy. You like big, meaty, juicy things in your mouth, Howard?
Sir, you are wild to go.
This is the rack of lamb.
I don't eat rack of lamb.
Well, you need to get rack of lamb.
I can eat some grouper.
Mini.
My
rack
wife
of
like
lamb.
Rack of lamb, and she like
mini
minced
rack
thing
of lamb. 4.
I'm out worrying right now. She's texting me.
Mini rack of lamb served with garlic, mashed potatoes, steamed vegetables, and mint jelly. You can get crab and rice. With any of the entrees for an additional $5 if you want. Now for the dessert, guava cheesecake. You like guava cheesecake. Stop playing.
Sir, sir.
You
sir.
Like guava cheesecake.
You're not
going to
look at my size and just assume that I like cake.
I apologize.
I love cake. Let's
I
go ahead.
I knew it. I knew it. You knew it. You can. Ladies and gentlemen, I was trying to swing people, you know. Don't assume that he come out tell the truth. It's going to ask me for my number. Good, I give him my number.
Good. Yeah.
Please feel free to give me a call. Ian Thomas, Direct Marketers at 552-0212. That's 552-0212. 552-0212. Give me a call, man. Hey, listen here, man. You're going to go get that all that good stuff down there at Sandy Port Poop Deck. The number again, 327-3325, 327-3325. Daring Millwork. Nah, this is another staying in line with...
We talked about this before.
Daring Millwork.
Yeah.
Listen, if you need electrical, an electrician, plumber, mason, carpenter, you need someone to do tiles, you need someone to do drywall, you want to give them a call. Everyone agrees that their home is probably their most biggest investment. I want you to call Daring Millwork right now. You want to choose a reputable company that does the work properly. They're doing some renovations at my house right now. I'm changing the bathroom, three bathrooms, and a kitchen.
When your wife has ever have time to relax?
Well, it's not
every week you're doing something. You didn't bring in a new beta testing.
With that, I'm renovating my pool.
You're renovating your pool?
Yep, I took all the water.
Then
out
you may have a party based upon.
I have a party there. I just built a pavilion.
You're building a pavilion.
I've already finished the pavilion.
So when I come to your front door, I should say under.
Under construction.
Sorry for the inconvenience. Under construction management.
I say, Howard, come on in.
You wilded out, sir.
Come
you
on
did
in.
Too much.
Here's your construction hat. So the phone number for Daring Millwork is 431-4774, 431-4774. You guys want to call them. If you want your work done properly, call these guys. They are amazing. All the workers are skilled, and they don't trouble you. They don't bother you. They don't ask you for nothing. They come in and do
their
work.
Water.
Yeah, boss, you got some water?
You all have any good.
Boss, you got no
light? You all have any good.
None of that stuff. Just... come on in. They get everything done. You want your kitchen, your bathroom done, your front porch, your patio, and they specialize in roof issues. They do painting and drywall, all the finished work right now. You have a leaky roof, you better get that fixed before the hurricane comes. I'm dead serious about that.
Yeah.
You dead serious about that. You got to get that fixed.
Yeah.
So now, I want you to go and check them out. This is the most cost-effective way to do renovations to your house. So if you want to fix up your apartment, your Airbnb, or your business, you want to call Daring Millwork.
You mean the apartment that people own it, not the apartment that people live in it?
No, you can't pick it up the people things, man. Someone asked me for the number right now. Daring Millwork, number one company, 431-4774, 431-4774. Go check them out. I've seen all the fantastic reviews about them online, and they have stood up to exactly what everyone's been saying about them. So I said, you need an electrician, a plumber, a mason, a carpenter, a tiler, a painter, anything you need. But
a tiler?
A tiler. Yeah.
T-Y-L-E-R?
No, Tyler. No.
Because it's a whole different difference.
Yeah, that's
sir,
a whole different thing.
This is too much.
Hey, listen, you remember back in the
Tyler.
Days, if someone call you and say, hey, I'm looking for a tranny, then you know someone probably going to go out and try to find a part for their car.
Did you?
Nowadays.
You are wilding out.
No
one says that.
Yes, they
We've
say, listen.
We've never called anyone saying, I'm looking for a tranny.
Say, listen, I'm looking for a tranny. You say,
we
sorry,
used to
know
call
that your
people
car
and
down.
Say, hey, listen. I'm calling to find out if your fridge running. And
yeah.
You say, yeah, my fridge running. I say, we go catch it. That was the length and breadth of it.
No, man, Howard.
Not for trannies. What are you saying? Go ahead. I'm not going to fight you. Right?
Hey, listen, you call Darren Millwork right now. His phones are ringing off, though. He just sent me a WhatsApp, and he says, Ian, tell the people happy Mother's Day coming in from them. All their work is guaranteed and warranted. The phone number is 431-4774. 431-4774. If you didn't get any of these numbers, ladies and gentlemen, feel free to give me a call. Ian Thomas, Direct Marketers at 552-0212.
552-0212.
Lastly, before I go, Howard, I got to tell you about one more company. You know when people need someplace to go. Howard, I spoke to you yesterday. You
Sometimes
told me
you
told me that your truck is down.
No, my truck is fixed,
Your truck
sir.
Is fixed.
My truck
ladies
is fixed.
Ladies and gentlemen, Howard's truck was down until yesterday, but he had an extra car.
Hey,
if
listen.
If you're not as lucky... go ahead.
I did. I got my part.
Yeah.
Because I was waiting on these guys to kind of bring my part in.
Mm-hmm.
Got my part. The guy came in. I was on the show. When I came back, my truck
was
fixed.
Running. Okay, then.
God
ladies
is good.
And gentlemen, if you're not as fortunate as Howard to have a multitude of cars.
You're doing
the
lot, sir.
And you don't have a car, or maybe your car might be down, or whatever it is. You want to get around, you want to call Triber. You know what Triber is? It's the same kind of company as Uber in the United States. It's a ride-sharing company, and it's the number one ride-sharing company in the Bahamas. So you want to give them a call at 826-7647, 826-7647. It's a magnificent company. All their drivers have been properly vetted, and all the vehicles are licensed and insured. Their motto is simple. This is a company that allows anyone and anything to be transported quickly, safely, and affordably anywhere in Nassau. So imagine you're sitting home. You want to get food from your favorite eatery. May it be a fast food joint or a restaurant or a fish fry. Give them a call. They'll pick it up for you. They pick up packages from UPS also. They do school pickups and drop-offs. They do work pickups and drop-offs. I said UPS drop-offs. If you want to get grocery from the store, they can carry you. You want to go to the bank, they can take you. That's no problem. You need something to go to the boat or the plane, they can do that for you. You need to get to the doctor's appointment, or maybe you're an elderly person who needs to go to NIV to get verified. That is not a problem.
What's it called?
It's called Triber. You can check them out online. And you can WhatsApp
Triber?
Them. Yeah, Triber.
Triber.
T-R-I-B-U-R. So that's a wonderful company. You can check them out on their, like I said, on their website at Triber.com.
So they can do all these things for you. So they ain't really just carrying you there.
No.
Because if I say, put Candace to the boat for
somewhere.
Me.
Yes.
They got to go
right.
Put it on
so
the boat.
So let's just say hypothetically, your wife has a boyfriend, right?
Sir, never say that hypothetically.
I'm just saying hypothetically. So let's say your wife has a boyfriend and she
wants
to
get... This is
a
horrible
hypothetical. It's a great analogy. Listen. And she wants her boyfriend to get picked up and drop somewhere.
We can't do that.
And drop somewhere. So this is
ideal. Is Triber working for Breaking Bad? That's the only way we can pick him up. Is we have to wrap him up too.
They've got a service available from 5 a.m. to 2 a.m.
5 a.m. to 2 a.m.?
So if you need your little movie pickup, your little sweetie, your little sneaky link, right? Because she said, okay, Howard has the car. I want my boyfriend to get picked up and get
you. You're wilding all the way out.
Howard, it's just a scenario.
This is Mother's Day. This is Mother's Day.
You have to get it. Okay, now for
Mother's
Day.
Let's be decent for Mother's Day.
So there's also a Mother's Day special happening right now. Anyone needing some floral arrangements dropped off to that special woman in their life, they have it starting at $25. Prices can increase due to
so
the
who's
mileage.
This?
This is Triber.
Triber has what?
If you want to go ahead and you want to do a Mother's Day pickup, like the
also,
from the flowers and everything.
So they can carry it to the...
Yes, they can carry it to go get your Mother's
so
Day.
So if I get a cooler coming from someplace, they could go pick it up and bring it for
they
me?
They can do anything to do with mobility, from transporting a person or a thing from one location to another
so
locale.
So I got to be there. I got to just say, hey, listen,
just
go out to this one,
that.
Boom, 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 pick
right.
up my cooler,
now,
bring it here.
Another good thing about them, short trips from under 5 miles are $10. Medium trips, 6 to 10 miles are $15. Longer trips are $30. And if you want something go from deep east to far out west, that can be $50.
So E&B all the time.
Stop waiting. Give them a call. Triber, 826-7647, 826-7647.
We are flat out of time. Ladies and gentlemen, I want you guys to enjoy yourselves over the weekend. Please give Ian a shout, 5520212, 5520212. There's a plethora of things that you can do and be able to enjoy yourself this weekend. Ensure that you have a good time with mommy. Make sure you dress up. She then can call y'all. Your big sister can call you. All y'all wear the same clothes and carry Grammy or mommy to church and enjoy yourselves this weekend. Be able to break bread with her and kind of enjoy the fact that she's still here with us. My mother's going to be here at the end of the month, right? I don't really think she's coming for me. She's listening to me. You know?
Okay.
She don't really care about me that much. She's coming for the F&M convention. She needs to stop.
Yes.
I know. I got to watch her, you know.
She loves
me. Oh, praise Jesus. Anyway, guys, enjoy your weekend. Have a beautiful weekend. I will see you on Monday. God spare our lives. Ian Thomas, all the way from Direct Marketers, being able to talk to us about these things. Grateful to you, my brother.
Thank you so much, Howard Grant. And remember, 96.9 FM, the number one station in the world.
You are something else. Have a good day, guys.
The foundation.
Contact DaVinci Printing Innovators today for all your printing needs. Customized receipt books, NCR forms, invitations, event tickets, program booklets, business and ID cards, flyers, posters, and banners. They're scanning, printing, lamination, and binding services. Also, a variety of office supplies. No design, no problem. Dedicated graphic designers are ready to serve you. DaVinci Printing Innovators, located in the Village Road Shopping Plaza. Stop in or call 677-2922 or browse services online at www.davinciprinting242.com.
printingnews.com, where printing is an art.
Here's to the go-getters, the early risers, and the late-night dreamers. You, the visionaries, painting futures in your mind, in your studio, your office, your sacred space. Here's to the adventurers, explorers of every realm. To you, the innovators, turning the cogs of progress in a world where connection is a lifeline, a pathway to possibilities. Alive is the perfect connection for everyone, every lifestyle. Every day.
Visit BeAlive.com today.
The Grand Bahama News is available every Tuesday in the Nassau Guardian. You can buy your local paper at Freeport convenience stores, Western Bakery, DeGregory's Fine Foods, and Bellevue Gifts. Now is the time to reach your Grand Bahama market with affordable packages, including print and digital. Call GB News sales representative Kavandre at 822-6717 or message him on WhatsApp for ad rates. Classified ads are now available every Tuesday as well. Keep up with everything Grand Bahamian every Tuesday in the Nassau Guardian.
Explore the wonders of the Bahamas at Sun, Sand, and Souvenirs, brought to you by the Tourism Development Corporation. This 8-store retail treasure chest is located on Bay Street, just 2 doors east of Bayside Food Store. Build a pal with your child. Purchase authentic Bahamian artwork or dazzling jewelry. It's a shopping adventure where the possibilities are endless. We're open 7 days a week, so join us today and let's create a community where innovation and opportunity thrive. See you there.
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM, Nassau, Bahamas.